Hi, it's Paul. I'm back here with some traffic lights, and I'm setting this up with Ladder Logic. Ladder Logic's not my favorite programming language, but it's a good place to start, and it's what most people are familiar with. So let's have a look. I'm using this factory I/O simulator for my traffic lights. So you can see the lights, one's red and one's green, and they go to amber and then red, and it switches back and forth. It's a real simple traffic system. I'm not using any of my walk, don't walk, and car sensor. I'm just using timers to make these lights flip back and forth between green, yellow, and red. Let's take a look at how I did it. Here we are with, I'm using Studio 5000, but you can do this the same way with pretty well any PLC programming software that uses ladder logic. So first let's look at the top here. I've got four timers, and basically one timer runs, and when it finishes, the done bit from that timer starts the next timer, and they just cascade all the way down. One thing you have to remember when you're doing cascading timers like this is the first one has to start with a normally closed done bit. If you don't do that, your timers will never start, and then all the rest are normally open. So play around with that if you're not sure why it works like that, and experiment a bit and you'll see that this is the way that it works. Okay, so I've got four timers, and obviously I'm running my lights a lot faster than they should be, but I've got the first one at 3000, which is 3 seconds, and then half a second, 3 seconds, and then half a second, just so I can run the sequence real quick. And what I'm doing is I'm looking at the timer timing bits on all of these timers to turn on my lights. So let's check how I'm doing that. Now I'll go down a bit, and the first thing that we have to consider is that the red lights have to be on while the green light's on and while the amber light is on. So we have two timers that turn on a red light. You can't have two outputs on different rungs, so what I did is I took my two red lights, my north red and my east red, and there's two different conditions that can turn those on. Timer one timer timing and timer two timer timing will turn on the north red. Okay, so that's my two reds, and then if I go down a little further, I've got my four other lights. I've got my east green, east yellow, north green, and north yellow. And those just link to each of the timer timing bits on my four timers. So it all seems to work. Now this is a good way to do a very simple light system, but if you tried to use this strategy for doing something more complex, it's going to get pretty confusing. For example, if you put in the walk, don't walk, well, the light has to switch from walk to don't walk prior to the traffic light going to amber, because pedestrians need some time to get across the street. So we can't just use these four basic timers for our walk and don't walk. We would have to add in some more timers. So it gets a little confusing. And then if we add in sensors, it's going to get more complex. So this works for a simple traffic light system, but there's a better way to do it for something more complex. And I'll go through that one next.